By changing the law on prosecution, the new government intended to replace people for whom it claimed were an obstacle to progress in the field of rule of law. Brussels insists that changes can also be made within the existing model. And as I understand, you pretty much have the same position. So do you at least to some extent understand the authorities' position that some major reforms are necessary, and how do you think that a compromise can be made?
The United States has followed the lead of the European Commission with their statements that Montenegro does have and has had the structures and institutions and laws in place that allows for the carrying out of rule of law. And that structure is one that should be used. Now, can laws be improved? In this human world of ours, anything can be improved. But there is a process, and the process that the Parliament has decided now to pursue, which is to delay and allow for consultations with the EU, is one we applaud. That's how an EU aspirant should engage with their future partners. We do want to see Montenegro able to break the cycle of weak engagement in addressing rule of law issues, and this is possibly an opportunity to have a very strong debate and potentially reforms, depending on what experts in the European Commission advise at the end of this process.
I would like to know, what's your position, what's your comment regarding yesterday's decision of higher court in Podgorica and suspension of criminal prosecution against high DPS official Slavoljub Migo Stjepović, involved in this well-known case, Koverte?
I don't have a specific comment. What I do want to say is that I think it is necessary for Montenegro to use the laws that it has and to show the political will to address corruption in all its forms.